There are shock new details in Victoria's deadly mushroom case, with police claiming Erin Patterson tried to kill her ex-husband four times before the fatal meal. The 49-year-old is now facing five charges of attempted murder as well as three charges of murder. We'll have live updates coming in from Currumburra and police headquarters as Erin Patterson spends her first night inside prison.
Victoria's most infamous home cook in custody, accused of devising a recipe for murder. Erin Patterson, now an accused killer, charged with three counts of murder and five counts of attempted murder. In a twist, four of the attempted murder charges relate to her ex-husband, Simon Patterson, between 2021 and the day of the toxic lunch, where she's accused of serving beef Wellington containing death cap mushrooms. Today, the mother of two faced a Morwell magistrate after spending her first night in a custody cell. She stared down reporters as she entered the room.
How's your client doing in custody?
She's good, thanks.
7 News can tonight reveal computer equipment seized from her Leongatha home yesterday was found hidden across the property and uncovered by the Federal Police detector dogs. This fresh evidence, police say, will now need to be analysed before the next court appearance, which they expect to take 20 weeks, time for them to analyse the seized evidence. Erin Patterson was softly spoken in court, wearing glasses and the same grey jumper she was wearing when she was arrested yesterday. The 49-year-old is facing three murder charges, the first over the death of Heather Wilkinson, who died on August 4 after the deadly meal, the second over Gail Patterson's death. The 70-year-old also died on August 4. The third murder charge relates to the death of Donald Patterson. He died on August 5. Erin Patterson is also facing five charges of attempted murder. The first for Ian Wilkinson, the local pastor who fought back from intensive care. The second attempted murder charge relates to her ex-husband, Simon Patterson, who was meant to be at that fatal lunch but never showed. Police will allege Ms. Patterson attempted to kill him on three previous occasions, once between November 16 and 17 in 2021, again in May 2022. And a third time in September that same year.
Will she be fighting these charges, Mr. Du?
It's early days and we haven't received a brief.
Erin Patterson's home address is widely known, but today a magistrate removed it from the charge sheets, stating if someone burns her house down, let's not hold the court to account. Police sources say Ian Wilkinson, the only survivor, has been critical in the case.
He's actually the only person who can give an alternative account to Erin Patterson's of what happened at that lunch.
But with wild speculation around the world, there's doubt if Erin Patterson can expect a fair trial.
That's something that the defence and Crown will discuss as to whether it should potentially be a jury trial or in fact go to judge only.
The next time we'll hear about this is in a few months' time, back in the Melbourne Magistrates Court as part of the committal hearing process. This is not likely to see the start of a committal hearing until the very end of 2024, perhaps even 2025.
And Cassie Zervos, the judge, was taken aback by a police request in court.
Well, Mitch, the 20-week delay appeared to come as a surprise to the magistrate, but he granted the request. Erin Patterson wasn't in a position to apply for bail and will spend her first night in prison. The mother of two will spend the next 6 months there before she faces a magistrate again in May next year for a committal hearing.